All right. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Tuesday again, but you know what that means. You know, the motherfucking Hot Tag Podcast. Tag? We are back. Hot Tag?
Hot Tag?
There you go. God damn it. We are back. It is Tuesday. Yours truly, Shaheen, my main man.
I am Boxman.
Yeah, he is not in jail. He's not a boxed man. He's just a box man.
Yes, I am a box man, and we got into that Saturday. If you don't know, listen to Saturday's show.
If you don't know, now you know.
It is an interesting, interesting time in wrestling. WWE finally does the right thing.
Ooh, yeah, nigga.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. Ooh, yeah.
I'm happy, dude.
It's about time.
That's my boy.
It's about time they did it. There was no reason not to, ever. I don't care what the rumors were. Fuck that, dude. This guy deserves to be in there.
Well, hold on 1 second. Don't get ahead of ourselves now. If he, and, you know, again, I'm going to go ahead and go with this theme of God may rest his soul, because this seems to be a theme throughout our show now. I'm saying, well, I mean, you know, it's not my fault. All these wrestlers are dead. You know? Can't blame me. Blame steroids, dude.
I can blame whoever the fuck I want, man.
True.
But I won't.
But Randy Savage, man, if he touched the 14-year-old Stephanie, then he probably doesn't deserve to be in the Hall of Fame. But that's not a fact, so he deserves to be.
We don't believe that.
I kind of actually believe it now.
No, I honestly believe the whole heat was the fact that Vince really thought a lot of him, and he didn't tell anybody he was leaving. He left. He went to WCW. And according to, you know, this is a story straight from Vince, it hurt Vince. He was hurt by it.
Yeah, but...
So, I mean, that could be the whole story. It could be that simple. I hope it is. I do, because I don't believe anything else besides that.
Let's keep this in mind. It's been 20 years since Macho Man left WWF.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, you don't think Vince would get over that? I mean, it's, you know, Vince has gotten over a lot worse stuff and worse circumstances. For example, the Ultimate Warrior.
Well, how long was he gone for, though? Warrior.
How long was that?
How long was Warrior gone? Almost 20 years.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
What?
Maybe it takes Vince 20 years to get over stuff.
Well, it's been 20 years. It's about damn time.
Do you know what I'm talking about? Maybe 20 years is his, some people are like, you know, 3 is a charm. Maybe for Vince, 20 is a charm.
He has OCD about the number 20.
Just, you know, you wait 20 years, you can come back to Vince and say, hey, I think I fucked up.
Now, do you think Nails could come back in 20 years?
Oh, Jesus. God, I hope not.
Well, never say that would be pretty cool, man. Seeing Nails go to the Hall of Fame for whooping Vince McMahon's ass.
It could happen. You never know.
Is there any truth to that rumor?
I don't know, man.
I mean, I've heard it a lot.
Dude, there's websites dedicated to these rumors.
Really?
Oh, yeah. There's one. There is one that actually is like all about the wrestling rumors.
Nice. Well,
oh, there's hundreds of them on the page.
I'd hate to see who that website is run by.
Yeah, probably Rob Feinstein.
Maybe.
Wrestling rumors.
Another thing throughout our show is bashing Rob Feinstein.
Well, that's what happens when you're a pedophile.
There you go. Bam! Another shot taken. Shots fired.
That's right. That's why we don't believe Macho Man did what they say he did. Let's see here. Wrestling rumors. There's a one that's got a ton of them, and I mean a ton.
Well, how about, all right, so this is going to be a short show, of course, because we already discussed TNA, we already discussed everything else. We just have Raw, since we did a Saturday show. So, yeah. If we have time, let's get into some of the rumors.
We can do that, and we can talk, and we can also talk some Lucha Underground.
Yes, I did actually watch the show, but then again, that's not going to take that long, because it was only one match, so.
It was. All right. What do you want to do? You want to get into this? You want to get into that? Or you want to get into Raw? You want to just start with Raw and get the fuck over with?
I guess, let me share this real quick.
Or do you want to bullshit for a while?
We can just bullshit for a while. Bullshit. Okay. Ryback teases wrestling on another channel. Have you heard of this?
Yeah.
This is hilarious.
Ryback is a internet goof.
Good marketing on his behalf, and maybe he'll get like 10 viewers for TNA by accident.
Yeah. That would be so funny if all three of them happened to show up over there.
That would be hilarious.
That would have been great. I got to tell you, last night during Raw, I saw three TNA Destination America commercials.
Yep. It's funny you mentioned that. I noticed that too. That's good, man. That's good. See, why didn't Spike TV do this? I don't get it.
You know, and I'm not sure if it was a Destination America buying it or if it was the cable company dropping it in there, but either way, it looks like Destination America is behind this company. I mean, I saw TNA ads on Raw. Don't get me wrong. I used to all the time, but I'd see one throughout the show.
This is honestly my first time seeing a TNA commercial on Raw.
I have before, and especially when they used to come, you know, local, I would see it. But again, that could be the cable company throwing them in. But I was happy to see him. Good. Let Destination America get some fucking juice behind him, and maybe, I don't know, man.
I don't think this was the cable provider throwing these commercials in there. Because again, like you said, those are more for like, I don't know, like local events and stuff like that.
Usually.
Yeah, like, you know, like the live shows and the house shows or whatever you want to call them. But yeah. I think this is Destination America, you know, getting behind TNA. Obviously, probably their strongest ratings on their, you know, channel. So I'm glad, you know, what did they do? Like a 3-point-something, 3.5?
No, they didn't.
Yeah, they did. They got a 3.5.
Really?
Yeah.
I just saw they had like a total of 400 and some viewers, but let's just hope it goes up and up and up.
From my understanding, TNA and Destination America, they put out a statement that the ratings were wrong, and you know they were gonna gather the ratings and the correct information will be put out to the public, and it never was, or maybe it was perhaps now, since you say that you heard 400-some. So maybe that's the correct number. Either way, it's about half of their viewers. Then again, it's not so bad, because remember when they changed, Spike TV changed TNA from what, Wednesday to Thursday, was it?
Thursday to
Wednesday?
Yes.
Okay, I had it backwards. And that actually, that cost them a couple hundred thousand fans for a couple months. So yeah, it takes some time, man. When they change channels or times, people have to adjust. A lot of fans will be lost until they, you know, they can find it again. And keep in mind, some people may not even have the channel, so.
Like, all of Canada doesn't have a way to watch.
Right, Destination right now.
They have no way at all to watch in Canada right now. So that's I mean, if it's a couple hundred thousand, it's a couple hundred thousand, you know?
Yeah.
But I don't know, man. I heard a lot of people saying that they were getting the show illegally in Canada. So
yeah, but that equals no money or ratings.
That does not add to the ratings, but I don't know. I mean, a lot of people did watch that first episode, I think. So, I don't know. Let's hope they get some juice behind them and they keep cranking.
Yeah, hopefully, man. Hopefully. I watched the show again, and I thoroughly enjoyed it, man. I thought it was a great show, actually.
Yeah, it was a pretty good show, man. You can't say it wasn't. You know, I like I said, I saw a lot of internet. Oh, the same shit, bullshit. Well, if you weren't really keeping up with it before, then you really have not much to say. But
I mean, honestly, it kind of is the same shit. But then again,
it is. But remember one thing: it was their first live show,
right?
New channel with, you know, hopefully when they've got a chance to cut and produce and do stuff in post, I don't know. We'll see what happens. Hopefully it'll be able to be a different show. I mean, they were talking about going the reality route, so let's see what happens. Let's see what happens Friday.
Yeah, we can see. You can kind of see the reality show effects in there already, you know.
Yeah.
Like the intro. I really like the intro, definitely. I mean, I know we went over it on Saturday, but fuck it. God damn it.
We're just glossing over it in the scheme of the wrestling world.
Wrestling.
Yeah. We can do it. It ain't no big deal. Like they say, her ain't no big deal.
I'm surprised there's no more wrestling in Texas.
Dude, and you know, it's funny. I went, man, you should have been here fucking 20 years ago. This place was, that's all they had here was fucking wrestling. And I'm like, yeah, no shit. Why did it fucking leave? What the hell?
Yeah.
It's there's few and far between any good wrestling here.
If you could rewind time, all right? Let's say you're in a time machine, right?
Okay.
Are you with me? All right. Let's say you're in a time machine. If you had to travel back and live in any city, country, state, whatever, wherever in the world, to witness that time period's wrestling events in that specific area, what city or country or state or town or fucking arena, where would you be?
It'd be here when the Sportatorium was kicking ass.
Now, world class?
Yeah. All the Sportatorium, dude, everybody.
Well, so you're older than me, so you appreciate like world class more than I do. I'm not really.
Yeah.
And I've watched it. I like it, but it's.
I loved it, man. Either here or in Atlanta. Cause I know Atlanta's always been a hotbed for the wrestling.
For WCW?
Yeah, it was NWA back then. And I mean, dude, I lived in North Carolina for 10 years, so I was right in a territory, so that was pretty badass too whenever they would come to town.
It's funny. It's kind of ironic how you probably wouldn't change cities, right? That's funny.
Probably not, but
not weird though.
The bad thing is I fucking hate it here. I really want to go back to Florida.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I thought everybody liked Texas. Good old Texas boys, ripping that country shit, man.
Man, fuck Texas. This place, it's fucking cold.
Dude, you don't know what cold is.
It's cold for me. I've been in Florida 16 years. My blood is thin. I drink. My blood is thinner.
You can't compare all temperatures to Florida temperatures, dude.
I can. When you spend 16 years in Florida, that's all you can compare to.
I guess.
I'm telling you, man, it's hilarious. I was born in Boston. You would never know it.
I guess.
I was born in Massachusetts, but I really became a wussy in Florida.
Man.
Dude, I mean, I think the coldest day I ever knew in Florida was like 42 degrees.
Jesus Christ. That's like summertime here.
Yeah. 42 fucking degrees, man. And dude, let me tell you what. In Florida, when it hits like 62, 65, you'll see these people with their winter coats on and shit. They wait to break out their winter jackets, bro.
That's insane, man. Can you imagine living in Canada?
I don't know, man. Trust me, man.
It's cold. I'll tell you. I have two I have two aunts living up there, dude. It's fucking freezing. And mind you, I live in the Northeast. It's already cold here. So if I say it's cold, believe me, it's cold.
Yeah. And the weird thing is every now and then it runs through my mind to move to Colorado.
Yeah. That's why I'm trying to get out of here, man. I got to get out of the Northeast.
Go to Colorado.
Yeah, Colorado would be sweet.
Everyone says Colorado, even though it's cold, there's always that bright sun. Even in the winter, so it's not as bad because of the sun.
Yeah, but I'd rather have heat than just the brightness of the sun.
Dude, let's go to Florida, man. We'll fucking, let's do this.
Do a live hot tag every week from the beach.
Live. Fuck all this. fuck all this internet shit.
Yeah, do it live. I'm trying to get something like that going at the Royal Rumble, man. I haven't really spoke to anybody about it, but I think that'd be sweet.
Yeah, we could do. I'm telling you, man, you can figure something out. If you got a phone, you got a way to get into here.
Yeah, yeah. I forgot. I mentioned that to you off the podcast.
Yeah, you said you don't remember much of Saturday. That's cool.
Yeah.
I'll keep reminding you, Shane.
Yeah, I forgot to mention that. Now I'm starting to recollect everything. Anyway, goddamn. So you would stay in Texas if you could go back in a time machine and go to any period of time for wrestling events. You would go back probably to the 70s in Texas, right?
How long am I here for?
How long were you there for?
How long is this time travel?
Let's say 10 years.
Oh,
you're gonna be there for 10 years.
Oh, then I'm going back to the Florida territories. If I'm here 10 years, I'm going to the Florida territories because I hear a lot about how they were back then, and I would go ahead and just do that shit then. 10 years? Yeah, Florida territories, my man.
You're surprising me.
Why?
Well, I just find it ironic that you know, you're obviously technically from Florida, but also you represent Texas now since you live there, but yeah, between those states, you probably stay in the same state, and I just find it ironic because I'd probably do the same thing. I'd probably stay in the Northeast because,
yeah,
I don't know, I just find it weird. We wouldn't really change places.
No. I mean, North Carolina was a pretty cool place. I got to see a lot of wrestling there, too, when my dad would take me. I don't know, man. I would probably, if I had to stay somewhere, I mean,
Wouldn't you want to be here in the 90s, man?
Be where?
What was that?
Where would I want to be in the 90s?
In Philadelphia in the 90s.
No, not really.
Dude, hands down, greatest time in wrestling.
Maybe in the 80s, because then maybe I could have been in that movie Trading Places.
Oh, no, no, no. ECW? Yeah, I know. ECW, you couldn't have had a better time than being at ECW as an adult male or woman. You know, adult beverages and good wrestling and fucking, you know, aggressive fans. It was a different atmosphere. I went to those shows, but I was a kid. You know, I was like 12, 13, so I couldn't really do anything. But I can only imagine, you know. So I would like to relive actually those memories as a grown man, so I could do what I do now. It'd be sweet. And also the indies, man. Don't forget the indies. We had like a Tri-State Wrestling Alliance, you know, all those fucking indies. it was good stuff, man. Terry Funk, Abdul the Butcher, Sabu was here all the time. Cactus Jack, Original Sheik, Kevin Sullivan, you know. Plus the WWF was still doing shows here.
True. Yeah. I don't know, man. Yeah, I guess you'd have the spot. But again, I would if I'm staying somewhere 10 years, I'm going somewhere fucking warm.
What about Puerto Rico? Would you want to be there?
I don't give a probably not. Ooh, wait. Well, it's Puerto Rican girls, man. I might. I don't know, man.
Dude, I love Puerto Rican women, but I would not want to live in Puerto Rico. I mean, it looks sweet, but from just what I hear, especially like back then, the time that we're talking about, like the 80s, where, yeah, you know, from what I hear, again, I don't know if this is fact, but from what I hear, they would sell rocks outside of the fucking arena so you can throw them at the wrestlers. I mean, that's bizarre.
That is kind of weird.
It's barbaric, man. I love it.
You bring your own batteries. It'd be easier. Cheaper.
Sure. Well, I don't know if it's cheaper, but...
Oh, you know. Yeah.
Well, rocks aren't costing that much.
Depends on how much they sold the rocks for.
Get them at wholesale, man. You got the rocks.
There you go. Fucking go in my backyard, grab a handful.
There you go, man. You know, in Puerto Rico, we're not talking about crack rocks. We're talking about real rocks.
Yeah, good point. Hey, I know this won't surprise you, but our chat room would go back and bang chicks that they didn't fuck. That's what our chat room would do with a time machine, and I applaud this chat room for that.
Well, I'm talking about wrestling, but yeah, you could always do that.
It's their choice.
It is their choice. We're all about the choices.
There you go. It's their choice. I'd probably do the same thing if I had access to a time machine. But
probably, yeah. Good times.
I don't know, man. We could go into total stoner talk and just go, do you think we'll ever have a time machine, man? What do you think, man? You think we're ever going to travel through time and space and end up back in the day? Huh?
Oh, man. Dude, man, we can, like, definitely do that some time.
No, we don't have that much time, dude. Fucking, I'll have to change the name of the show to Pot Talk.
Travel to, like, Mars, dude. Try to have, like, a session with the Mars. With the Martians. Have some wrestling talk. The Martians, dude.
Dude.
Oh, dude, totally. That shit would rock, man.
I feel like Keanu Reeves right now.
Totally.
Woo! There you go. That was my Keanu impression.
Oh, man, I would love to play his role and get paid to just talk like that for, like, months.
Dude, he had two movies, and that was his whole role.
I love the hippie, like stoner voice. It's so fucking easy and, like comfortable to just, like, oh, man, wow.
Bill and Ted was his best movie. Bill and Ted and Point Break. That was him right there. That was his.
Yeah. I got the box set, by the way, man.
Nice. He was good. I liked him in, of course, Matrix, and he was all good. And then he had to bring in the surfer talk with, "Well, I think I can bring him back."
What movie was that from?
Matrix, when he was going to get Morpheus.
Yeah, I don't remember that.
You'll die, and he's like, "I think I can bring him back, bro."
Yeah, I remember you'll die for it. I don't know. I haven't watched the Matrix in like 10 years, though. So.
And the other
time, guys.
I do want to let you know the other half of our chat room will go back and stop the birth of John Cena.
Nice. I agree with that. Why? That's pretty fucking harsh, dude. But you know, for the sake of pro wrestling, I mean, he's like fucking cancer to like pro wrestling, dude. Like I did totally just like kick the guys the fuck out.
You know, it would be funny if you did that. And then you came back to the 2015, and there was like WWE, and you're like, whoa, what did I do? Wait a minute.
Oh man, that would suck.
That would really suck.
That would suck. That'd be terrible.
But maybe if that happened, maybe WCW would have been the winner and survived, and maybe it could have been a different time. Now we're getting into real pot talk, motherfucker. Are you still there?
Maybe what?
Maybe.
Yeah, you locked up for a second.
Maybe WCW would have survived without John Cena. Maybe WCW would have won if John Cena was never around, and they would have become the number one company, man. And then, what's going to happen?
Well, I don't think. Cena had nothing to do with WCW's downfall.
No, but, I mean, he came in A little bit. When
don't,
did he come?
Don't credit Cena for that, dude.
Oh no, 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 no. I'm not. I'm just saying, you know, maybe if that whole, you know, maybe if what would happen if he did go back in a time machine and WWE was the one that lost that war. You went and let's say you went back and told WCW what was going to happen and how to fix it and don't make David Arquette champion and shit like that.
Well,
and tell Vince Russo to take a fucking walk.
Speaking of Dave Arquette, did you hear him on Sam Roberts' podcast?
Yeah, he didn't sound like himself.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. He kind of sounds like the Keanu Reeves impression that you were doing.
Yeah, he used to sound all like, hey, what's going on? And now he was like, yeah. So, anyway, I was, but I don't know, man. I did hear that, and it was a pretty good interview, actually. They did a good amount of wrestling talk, and I don't know, man. It seemed like he did have respect for the business. He did tell him he didn't want to do it.
Yeah.
I mean, he said no, but, you know, and as bad as that was, you know, that did put some eyes on WCW at the time, so whatever. I didn't think it was that bad, to be honest with you. I still say if WWE had a star right now that was a wrestler, they'd put the championship on him. Yeah, think I lost Shaheen. Shaheen, where did you go?
You there?
I'm here. You, oh man, I lost you.
Yeah, you locked up for like a couple minutes. It almost felt like. What were you saying? All I heard was he had respect for the business.
No, I just thought he had. I mean, he told him he didn't want to do it and everything. I thought he had a respect, and I don't know, man. I don't think he had anything to do with it. I think he just did what he was told because he told him he would do it. I think I think it's funny they said if you stay, what, 2 more weeks, we'll put the belt on you? That's kind of funny.
Yeah, I mean, he was there to do a job. His job. Are you there?
I'm here, man. I'm waiting for you to talk.
I don't know what's going on here.
Can you hear me?
We're in a goddamn submarine.
We are... We all live in a yellow submarine, man. Can you hear me? Am I talking to myself?
What the hell? I don't know what's going on, man. It's crazy in here.
Can you hear me, though?
You sound like a robot. That's all I know.
Oh, great. Now, now I sound like a robot. Am I still a robot? Man,
that's all I've been. Not anymore, really. You were for the last, like, 5 minutes, though.
I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. I didn't do nothing. I'm not touching anything or anything.
Yeah, all good, man. What were you...
Again?
I don't remember what we're talking about.
We're talking about...
Anyway. Everything.
We're talking about David Arquette. We're talking about everything in the world.
Yeah.
You want to just get into this fucking show?
I guess, man.
Let's just get it. Let's get this shit over with.
All right. Well, Raw started out with John Cena.
Yep.
Right.
I knew I'm gonna be happy about that shit.
Right. Seems to be a pattern. So, John Cena comes out. He feels all little John Cena, little teddy bear John Cena. Songman should make a song about John Cena. I'd like to hear that.
Oh God!
Fucking this guy comes
out. John Cena, he touched my wiener, but
he touched his wiener and made him gay.
Touched my wiener, I said I haven't seen ya. Yay!
That's what it would sound like.
I said, touch my wiener, yay.
You're breaking up the last couple seconds. Anyway.
I was just singing the song. Go ahead.
Yeah. Anyway, John Cena comes out. I guess we're supposed to feel sympathetic towards this guy because, you know, he's a big-time hero, and he meant to do good, and, you know, now his friends lost their job. So he wants to regain that momentum and be everyone's hero again and be that, you know, fucking baby face, essentially. Yeah, the big-time baby face that he's been for the last, what, 12 years?
Yeah.
Am I right? 12 years? Has it been? 12 years? 10 years?
You got it.
There you go. I was hoping I was wrong, but apparently I'm not. Damn, that sounds terrible.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah. So I salute all the wrestling fans that have put up with this guy's shit for 10, 12 years, because I sure as hell didn't. And I won't. If he's going to be around for the next 10 years, I'll say my goodbye now. But yeah, this guy comes out. He you know, the Authority comes out as well, and they have a face off, just like they had the last, what, 60 weeks. So I mean, you know, same old shit. They basically put a matchup against Seth Rollins against John Cena, and if John Cena defeats Seth Rollins, all his friends get their jobs back. So what did you think of this match, man?
It wasn't horrible. It, you know what? It might have been probably the best match on the show. I didn't find it too bad. I kind of knew where it was going because I kind of heard that they were looking to keep them off the rest of the week and do something to get them back next week. So, I don't know. The match itself was pretty good, though. I really didn't have much of a problem with it.
Yeah. It was a lumberjack match. So all the heels were out.
Yeah, they were. The chat room loved my song, by the way.
Nice.
Thank you.
Take over Songland.
I do it for you guys. I only do it for you. No one else can make Cena and Wiener rhyme the way I can.
Cena and Wiener.
No one can make it rhyme like me.
Man.
I am taking a bow, chat room.
That is something to be proud of.
That's right. Cheer for me. Thank you. Thank you. Please sit down. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Is everybody sitting now?
Yeah, they're all sitting. It's cool.
Everybody,
you can go.
Everybody's good?
You can go ahead.
In the back, everybody sitting now?
Oh, I shouldn't have chugged that first.
Thumbs up? All right.
Go ahead.
Good. All right. Nice. What were you talking? All right. John Cena and Seth Rollins got the lumberjack match, all heels. Big Show, of course. You know, honestly, how do you feel about Big Show? Because I'm going to let you get into this in a second. Big Show, I actually don't mind him as much as I did when he was a face. So I just hope that they leave him as a heel for the rest of his career and just stop fucking with this guy. Just leave him alone. He's pretty fucking bad, but he's terrible as a face now. So just leave him as a heel and let him be kind of bad and just play the background. What do you think?
All right. Here's my thing on Big Show. Every time he does heel Big Show, I look at Big Show and I go, this is how Big Show should have been booked since day one. You want to have a career babyface with John Cena, you should have had a career heel with the big giant guy. You never should have had him coming out there dancing and being a fucking moron. But you did. So now, I don't really give a fuck about Big Show. I don't. I just don't give a shit. I think him and Kane should both take their fucking balls and go home.
Well, no one cares about the Big Show, but would you rather have him as a face or a heel? I prefer a heel.
Gone.
Yeah, I definitely want him gone, but clearly that's not happening.
Well, I mean, basically I just said I do prefer heel Big Show, but I think that's where he should have been. He never should. I just don't understand why you would take a guy like that. He's a monster giant. Why would you? What?
Yeah, I don't mean, don't get me wrong. I absolutely 100% agree with you, man. That guy, he was booked. One guy that WCW didn't fuck up was Big Show.
Well, I mean, maybe a little bit with all the, you know, all the Dungeon of Doom stuff, a little bit, but still, they never booked him to be a fool. You're right. You're right. You know what? I take back what I said. You're right.
He won the title in his debut with Dungeon of Doom. I mean, it was 95, dude. You know, so keep that in mind and in perspective.
I took it back. I said they never made him look like a fool. You're right.
I mean, WWF had Quang at that time, so.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Quang. Yeah. Who were some other memorable, terrible gimmicks during the 95 era?
Oh, I took. I wasn't watching in. I think I took that year off in 95. That was the year after I graduated. Oh, yeah. I don't remember much of that year. 95's kind of a blur.
I was like 8.
I was 20.
Damn. Anyway, who was that one guy? Fantasio? He was around in 95. He had like 5 matches. Fantasio? Phantasm? What the fuck was it?
Phantasmo.
There you go.
The guy who would pull the magician.
Was he the fake Sting?
I think. No. I don't think. Maybe. What? No. I don't think so.
I don't know why I thought that. But I think he probably would have been a better fake Sting than the fake Sting that there was.
Been a better fake Sting than fake Sting?
Yeah, he would have been a better fake Sting than fake Sting.
God, I love this. This is fun.
we should just bullshit every week instead of talking about Raw until it gets better, man. That shit sucks.
Yeah, we're just good. We hit the matches, we talk, we hit the match, we talk. We're fine.
Yeah, I guess. Since
I think the format we're doing
is to go over the damn show.
Do what?
Since you insist.
I don't insist. I just. I don't know.
We're 95, so, you know, 2000. We're rewinding 20 years. Let's go back in time. 95. You graduated. Wrestling was terrible. Giant was a champion. We had. What was it? Phantasmo, you said?
Yeah, and you know what? I hadn't just graduated. I would have been 20 in 95. So, wow, I pretty much like 93 to 97 is kind of like a blur.
I loved 93, man. That was one of my favorite years.
I really partied a lot, dude.
Well, yeah, I was like a fucking kid.
Yeah. Let's see, I moved to Florida.
93 is actually the year that I really got into wrestling, like as a kid.
Yeah, I moved to Florida in 91. I didn't watch much wrestling when I first moved there, and then about the end of 95, 96 is when I started watching again.
Yeah. Pretty much from like 93 to 2002, I watched wrestling just nonstop, like every week.
Ah.
And of course, once I like, you know, graduated high school and all that stuff.
Yeah. Right around 96 is when I got I finally quit just staying at friends' places and got my own place, and I was having parties and shit there every Monday and pay-per-view parties and stuff.
There you go.
And I still don't remember much of what happened then, but.
I wish people still gave a shit about wrestling, so, like, you know, wrestling parties would still exist. I mean, I know some people probably still have them, but...
Oh, yeah, but, I mean, I know, man. I used to have, like, 15, 20 people at my house on a Sunday for a pay-per-view.
Dude, I can't... None of my friends like wrestling.
Yeah, I would have 2 TVs playing it. You know, I'd have one in the back and one in my living room playing, and, you know, people would be in the back playing... I had a foosball table back there. So they'd be back there playing foosball. We'd be out there drinking, talking shit, and watching wrestling. And man, those were the good old days, man.
Yeah, man, that sounds like a good time.
Yeah, the guy that used to, when we first started the show, the guy, my friend Joe that used to come in here from Florida, used to, he was always there.
Nice.
Yeah, he was always at those parties. He made a great punch.
Yeah, we were having all the audio problems. He probably was going to fuck these guys.
I don't know. I need to talk to him.
But, yeah, man. Fucking, I was in Germany around that time. I was watching wrestling in Germany. And the nice thing about Germany was you got the pay-per-views for free, so.
Well, at that time.
So did I at that time.
Yeah.
Those were the black box days, man. Those were black box days.
Yeah.
I had a black box and a VCR case that a buddy gave me.
Damn.
The thing had it was literally a PC board in a plastic VCR clamshell. Boom. That was it right there.
Sounds shady.
Worked like a charm, man. I didn't care. He gave it to me for he told me to give him $2 and I gave him $2 for it. And I'm like, you gave it to me. And it worked. So I didn't care. I figured even if it didn't work, I spent $2. Who cared?
That's a hell of a deal.
Yeah. Yeah. He needed
a hell of a deal.
Yeah, he needed a pack of cigarettes. And at the laundromat, they were still only $1.75.
Man.
Yeah.
The fuck?
There was a laundromat down in Florida that had cigarettes in the machine for like $1.75 till after I graduated. And then they finally went up. People, that place was always crowded with people at that machine.
Dude, like cigarettes are like $9 now.
Oh, they're like $5 here, $6.
Yeah, that's insane.
That was one of the reasons I quit smoking, man. That shit was getting expensive.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. When you got kids, you can be spending your money. Yeah. Yeah. I got tired of spending all that money on cigarettes.
There you go, man. But let's
yeah, you know, kids and a girl and shit, they start blaming you for being broke, so.
Yeah, well I'm trying to escape that.
Yeah. So I just said, well fuck it, I'll quit, then you're gonna blame me for shit.
There you go, man. Plan is smart.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or plan B.
Plan B. The healthy plan.
Like the plan, like the fucking pill, you know?
There you go.
Like the pill. But let's go back to reality and let's go back to last night's Raw.
See, you told me I was
knocked out. What was that?
You said I was the one that always insisted on this. Gee.
Well, I'm insisting on going back so we can finish it faster.
Alright, let's get this shit done. We only how many matches we got? Let's see. We got 8 matches in run number 2.
Alright, well we didn't finish number 1 yet, but we knocked out John Cena and yeah, Seth Rollins pinned him and Dolph Ziggler, Ryback, and what's the other guy's name? Eric Rowan. He's not coming back. So folks, that means that they're coming back. Royal Rumble, expect them back. For sure. I mean, if they're not back by Royal Rumble, I'd really be surprised.
Yeah. Yeah, I would think they're either going to be back Monday or they could do something on SmackDown to get people going to SmackDown too.
It's
possible.
Definitely be smart.
Well, they got Daniel Bryan debuting, you know, having his first match back on SmackDown, which isn't that bad of an idea either.
Right. In fact, that's actually probably the method that they're going with is having a couple big time angles and you know matches on SmackDown to gain some viewers, and you know of course it'll go back to the same shit in a few months. So.
I'm not even sure if I set it to record. I'll find out.
I have no desire.
Yeah. I like to record in case somebody ever says, "Oh, this happened on SmackDown." I can go watch it.
Right.
Yeah.
What was the next match?
Well, before the next match, we got a little backstage thing with Dean Ambrose. Actually, it was let's see, who was it? It was the Usos first, with Stephanie talking to him and basically saying they did something on SmackDown. Who the fuck knows? Why not tell us? And then Dean Ambrose comes in and he has to go see a psychiatrist.
Yeah. I don't. Who knows, man? I
mean, yeah. Now, by the way, this psychiatrist was fucking gassed up, man. This was a big dude for a psychiatrist.
He was probably a wrestler.
You think this dude has had some fucking arms on him, dude?
Yeah. He's a terrible actor, though. So.
Well, see, that was the worst cry I've ever seen in my life.
It was horrible.
Oh, God. Well, we got more to that to get into in a little bit. Before that, let's go ahead and get into the match that Shaheen asked me about, which was
New Day? New Day?
Versus Cesaro and Tyson Kidd.
Yes, sir. I love Cesaro and Tyson Kidd as a tag team. I'm
yeah,
just going to go ahead and lay it out there.
This match made me want to cry.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
After the New Day defeats them, yeah, it makes you want to cry.
Yeah, I mean, really, the New Day is about to be the flop of the year. You got Cesaro and Tyson Kidd. They're talented. The crowd likes them. You just did a little thing with them last week. Made no sense to me to have New Day go over here, but that's just me. What do you think?
Well, I think the New Day sucks, and I think that Tyson Kidd and Cesaro are a phenomenal team. Honestly, if they're not going to do anything with Cesaro and take him serious as a single act, might as well put him in a tag team. The tag team division has no depth. I guess they've had the Ascension and the New Days. What are they called? Is it New Day or New Days?
It's the New Day.
Can we go ahead and say that is probably the worst name of all time for a group, for a faction?
The worst name, yes.
Of all time. Like, literally.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
The New Day. I mean.
Yeah.
God. I feel bad for Kofi, man. They have to hate this. Like.
I don't know, man. I mean, you're sitting there watching, New Japan, and you're getting team names, time splitters, and all this good stuff, and we get the New Day.
Yeah, I love the name Time Splitters, man. That's
man. Like I said, I love their fucking logo. It's all Back to the Futured out. And
oh yeah,
it's pretty cool. I like it, but
Creative, man. It's creative. You know, that's what you get when you have Jado and Jado, two fucking guys that are behind this. Not 26, not 37. That's when the product goes to shit, because you have 40 people with 40 different opinions and state of minds that are all just, trying to put their input together, and it just collapses.
All trying to get their shit in.
All trying to get their shit in.
Trying to get their shit in. And that's what happens. You get
tons. Yeah, but I like that swing that Cesaro did, and then Tyson Kidd did the drop kick while he was doing the swing. I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was pretty good. I mean, these two are definitely going to be good. I just hope they give them an actual push. Losing to the New Day, Kofi and Xavier isn't exactly the best way to get these boys out there and get them over. And by the way, the second thing I want to say about Cesaro and Tyson Kidd, please, WWE, I'm asking very nicely, please, pretty please, with a cherry on top, get them away from Adam Rose right this second.
That's Are they still with Adam Rose?
Adam Rose was ringside with them.
You're kidding. I missed that. No way.
Yes, Adam Rose and the Rosebuds were all down there. He was ringside, and I'm just shaking my head. God, please don't make him a fucking manager. He doesn't. No, get him off the show. But
they have to stop this, man.
Yeah, don't manage these guys. There's tons of guys.
Yeah, go manage like Titus O'Neil.
You want someone to manage? You want someone to manage these two? You've got tons of people. You've got Flair. You've got Hogan, although Hogan will go into business for himself. You can't do that.
No, Hogan would be terrible. Flair would be a good one.
You could put Flair with him.
Yeah. That's about it.
Put Flair with him. The Enforcer. Put Arn out there.
Or just don't put anybody out there. They're good enough as their own.
Yeah, but I'm saying if you're going to give him someone to go out there with, give him someone that's going to give him some credibility.
They already have Natalie. I mean, just I said Natalie. What's her name?
Natalia. Natty. Whatever. Just call her Natty Light. I don't
know. Natty Light. Yeah. Natty. There you go, man.
And I, oh my God, we're sitting here calling this guy Tyson Kidd, Natty's husband. That's who we're talking about.
Natty.
I'm calling him by his name. What are we talking? Jesus, calling this guy by his fucking name. Oh God, I feel horrible. Natty's husband. Natty's husband.
Terrible people.
Yeah, we are.
We're some terrible wrestling podcast journalists.
Yeah, but people know that already, so who cares?
Those names, right?
Yeah. Then we get into another big show promo.
Please go. I have nothing to say. Please.
My God, it's not working. Oh, no. Hold on. This isn't working.
You asshole.
Oh, my God.
Can you dig it?
No, I don't want to play that, though. I'll figure out what happened.
I'm not digging it.
Here, hold on. Please hold for 1 second while we get our soundboard going correctly. All right, that one's not going to work. I'll have to get it again. No okay.
All right, let's go. Next one. What do we have? Come on.
After the whole Big Show thing, we get into... Where were we? Give me a second here. New Day. Roman Reigns comes out.
Oh, this match.
This match. Roman Reigns comes out and cuts something like a promo.
Well, it was a promo of the year.
They have got to take the fucking mic away from this guy. Please, please. No,
it's not even him. It's the garbage they give this guy. The magic bean... And the fucking beanstalk, like, come on, man. They had him do the fucking, what was it, Red Riding Hood and the Bad Wolf and now the beanstalk. Like, come on. Really?
Yeah, I guess so, man. It was so bad. It was childish. Childish. And he stammers through the goddamn promos.
Dude, I'll tell you what it is, man. It's because he's related to The Rock. They expect this guy to get away with this shit. Like, if you give The Rock Red Riding Hood, he'll make something funny out of it. You know? This guy is not The Rock, man. He's not. Stop trying to give him all this fucking child humor and child-friendly material to work with and still related to us, you know, the fucking 20 to 40 to 50... Eight-year-old. What the fuck am I talking about? God damn.
You're good. You're good, Shane. Calm down.
It's similar to Saturday again. All right. Bear with me, folks. If you weren't here on Saturday, I was struggling because I had some pain, so I took some painkillers and kind of put me out for a little bit. But I'm back.
He's back.
And I'm better than ever. I'm back.
Yeah.
I'm better than ever. I'm back. Yeah.
Sing that shit.
Singing that shit.
Sing that shit.
Motherfucker, Gucci Man just up in here, motherfucker, man. Singing that shit, man. We out here, man. We on Raw. Was it January 12th? What we discussed in Box, man? What's the next topic of discussion on the motherfucking paper that you took notes on for the Gucci Man to discuss and review?
Roman Reigns and Luke Harper.
Roman Reigns, that's my motherfucking boy. That's my boy, man. Believe that. Believe that, man. Believe that, because Gucci Man said that shit is hot, man. Believe that.
Yeah, what he said.
That. All right, in all seriousness, that shit was garbage, man. Stop giving this guy garbage to work with. I don't think he's that bad. I mean, when you saw him do the Macho Man thing, the Macho Man impression, you can see he has a little bit of charisma. I mean, the guy, I'm sure he can do better than what he's doing now. It's just the material they give him. I honestly think it's that. I think he's taking a lot of the heat for no reason, because people just want to hate him because they see John Cena in him. And I see that, so I can see myself hating him in a couple months. Right now, I don't mind the guy. But, yeah, I don't know, man. I wish him the best, because I think them just shoving him down our throat is not going to work with this guy. I think people are far too vocal nowadays, and they're not going to put up with this shit.
I think you got a point.
Yeah.
I think you got a little bit of a point there, Mr. Shaheen.
Well, that was Gucci Mane's idea. I just stole it from him.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. You said it as you, so, man, I don't even have the "you was crying like a pussy" sound. Oh, yeah, I do. I got it.
They're crying like a pussy.
I don't have it. I got it. I'm having to fix a couple right now that obviously
crying aren't. Like a pussy.
I don't have it right now.
It's all good, bro. Man, we got Gucci Mane up in here, man. Don't need no sound effects, man. You got top-notch star up in here, man.
Yeah, great.
Grammy-nominated Gucci Mane and shit, man.
Give me a minute. I'm almost done.
What we almost done with, man? We ain't almost done with Raw, man. WWE, man. I'm a fanboy, man. That's my motherfucking shit, man. Shit, man. Gucci.
God damn. Are you sure? Are you drunk?
I am not.
You should be.
I guess. I don't drink, dude.
You should be.
I don't drink. I think I say this every show.
I'm like, man, you must be fucking drunk. That's good.
Sober.
That's fucking good. That's all I got to say.
Anyway, right. Back to the show. So, yeah, Roman Reigns and Luke Harper. I think this is actually a good, I can't say it was a good match, but it's a good matchup. I'd like to see them have more matches, maybe even a pay-per-view match if they actually have a build-up to it. Both big guys. It looked good in the ring, but yeah, I don't know, man. It wasn't really much of a match since Big Show, of course, got in there, but it was cool.
Yeah, you're right. Wasn't bad at all, man. I agree.
It was cool. It was better than most of the shit that we saw, so can't really complain much about this.
You're right.
Although, I'll tell you, that promo, that was definitely one of the worst parts of the night. But, again, I don't put much of the blame on Roman, because I think he probably hates it as much as we do. I don't think the guy likes it. And for people saying that he's always winking at the camera and shit, dude, they're asking him to do that. I don't think the guy's just winking at the camera.
Oh, I don't think he's that creative.
Plus, I don't think he would want to do that. It's so corny, man. I mean, come on. You know? Are you there? Box man.
I'm here. I heard. I you lost me at corny. You lost me at corny.
Yeah, fuck it. I don't feel like repeating. Actually, I forgot what I said. Anyway.
Don't.
Well, I would if I could, but just listen to it on the download.
Yeah, there we go.
Subscribe to on iTunes and Stitcher under THT Wrestling Podcast. So go ahead and join us. THT Wrestling Podcast, iTunes, Stitcher, sign up, subscribe. Don't sign up because it's free. Just subscribe. It's still free. Either way, it's good stuff. The man with the box.
What?
Next match, please.
All right, next. Oh, hold on. I'm trying to get our soundboard working right now. Let me see something here, real quick.
All right, he was crying like a pussy.
Hey, yeah, there we go.
Crying like a pussy.
I got this motherfucker working again.
There you go, man.
Let's just make sure they all work. Cause right when we were about to do I was about to do this during the when Big Show. Ah, we got them all working again.
Nice.
Yeah, we got them all working. There we go. Good to go.
All right. What do we have next on the matches, man?
Oh. Let me go back to that cricket sound effects. Alicia Fox versus Naomi.
Oh, man. Thank you.
Next match was, I'm sorry, Alicia Fox wins. The next match was The Miz versus Jey Uso.
Can we get an encore? Please? Thank you.
There you go.
Fuck cares about this match?
Yeah, I'm with you, man. I'm right there with you.
Even put this on there, I mean. Oh, man.
You got me, man. They do some weird stuff, but you got me, man. I don't know. But, yeah, that was another match. Yeah, this match wasn't that. Well, yeah, it was. Anyway, Miz wins.
Yeah. Next, we got Daniel Bryan. He came out to a big pop.
Yep.
And may I go ahead and vent on Daniel Bryan for a second?
Oh, please do.
All right. I love Daniel Bryan. Let me just go ahead and say that. All right? And I think he's very talented in the ring. I don't think he's really good on the mic at all. In fact, I think he's actually pretty bad. But the whole yes thing is starting to bore me and kind of get on my nerves, actually. Where do you stand on this whole thing? On the yes movement, actually.
It's not that bad. It doesn't bother me. I like the guy.
I mean, how long can you listen? I mean, dude, like 3 years still? Yes, yes.
Yeah, I mean, trust me. Is it running its course? Yeah. Thank God the guy was gone for a little while, because otherwise it would probably have been immensely annoying by now. But I think maybe him leaving might have made it a little bit better, you know?
That it's, I mean, not seeing him back again, just, I mean, I don't know. And I don't want to complain about everything, but I don't know. I like the guy a lot. I'm excited to see him wrestle. I just think he's so much better than just you know, coming out there and doing the yes thing. You know, maybe not even do the yes thing for a while, you know.
Huh. There's an idea.
Right? Outside the box, right?
There you go. But you know that WWE, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Well, I mean, it makes sense. If it's not, yeah, I mean, I understand why they wouldn't fix it, but eventually I think it's going to end up backfiring and people are just going to hate him for it. Because it is going to get annoying. It's going to be like that, I mean, I can't really compare it to the what chant, because that's really annoying. But I think it's going to be up there.
I never minded the what chant.
The what chant is like the worst shit to happen to wrestling.
It never bothered me.
You don't find it annoying?
No. I find it disrespectful to some people, but...
Absolutely, yeah.
But, you know, I've only found it disrespectful one time, and that's when they were doing it to The Undertaker, but...
Yeah, I mean...
Otherwise, I've never really minded it. It doesn't bother me one bit, man. I don't care. Doesn't bother me.
I'm not a fan of the one chant. But anyway. Stephanie comes out and basically says, yes, you've defeated my husband and you've made history at WrestleMania 30, but it's not happening again. Nope. And she plugged her workout DVD in there, and Daniel Bryan kind of shitted on it, which is weird because it's like, all right, well, why would you try to advertise your product on your own show and halfway shit on it? What was that?
As a heel.
Right.
Trying to push your product as a heel.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that made no sense to me either. I'm glad someone else brought it up. So.
Weird. Very weird.
Yeah.
And she actually kind of made fun of him and said that like he's like small, so she doesn't know if like, you know, his workout is going to be the same as hers. It's going to be the same like weight division or some stupid bullshit.
Yeah.
Okay. Kane comes out. Corporate Kane comes out. I'm Michael. That's Corporate Kane, Michael. Fucking Corporate Kane comes out, and Daniel Bryan actually kind of he came off in the beginning. He kind of looked off a little bit. I don't know if you noticed it or not. But his chemistry with Kane was definitely off. I mean, his rhythm was just off. I guess it's because, you know, clearly he hasn't been in the ring for some time. But yeah. I definitely picked it up after a couple seconds, and he beat the shit out of Kane, so I enjoyed that.
Yeah, and obviously he's not going to slow down. That suicide dive out of the ring told me that.
Clearly not. One thing, dude, chill the fuck out.
Yeah, yeah. Nah. If he thought he was going to back off a little bit, I don't think that's going to happen.
Stop it, Brian. I mean, come on, dude. I mean, it's so sad, man, and this is off topic again, but fuck it. You know, it's so weird seeing history almost repeat itself, and I'm saying almost because that's the key word, and what I mean by that is you look at the 80s and the 90s, right? Those were the steroid age, right? The steroid era, I should say. Mm-hmm. Steroid cocaine era of pro wrestling. And now you're finally seeing the after effects at these conventions and all the early deaths and so forth, correct?
Oh, man, you're going to make me say something bad about cocaine?
I mean, you personally don't have to. I'm just...
To be honest, I've never done cocaine. But go ahead. Yeah, I know. I actually agree.
Yeah, but, you know, the cocaine and the steroid era clearly, you know, cost a lot of wrestlers their lives, their families, and et cetera, right? Yeah. Now, what was that?
Yeah, bro.
There you go, bro. But now, I hope I'm wrong on this. I usually don't wish that I'm wrong, but I hope I'm wrong on this. But I have a feeling in 20 years, in 10 years, 15 years, whatever the case may be, you're going to see a lot of these wrestlers, these current wrestlers, that are doing moves like Brian, people that are doing the high-flying shit. You're going to see a lot of these wrestlers in wheelchairs and kind of just chalked up in the corner somewhere at the convention. And it's not because of steroids and cocaine. It's because of their in-ring style. So it's kind of weird seeing how generations change over time and how, I don't want to say they have their own kind of demons, but they have their own kind of downfalls and something that essentially just breaks them down, you know, physically, emotionally, everything.
Yeah. And
can't you see that happening?
Well, I mean, dude, we talked about it Saturday with Jeff Hardy and that bump he took.
Yeah. That's another guy. Well, can we get this? Can we get a chill the fuck out button? If we just press chill the fuck out.
Probably.
Let's make that happen. Because a lot of these wrestlers need it.
A lot, dude. No shit. But I don't know, man. I definitely agree with you, though. I definitely see what's gonna happen. But and you know what? You could probably name the guy that's gonna happen to. You're gonna see probably Hardy, probably Brian. If Punk didn't get out, I would have said him. But I think he's gonna be okay. He's gonna have a lot of time to heal since he's out early.
Well, I mean, Punk was never really like a high-flying risk taker. He was just...
Well, back in his days, he was. He took a little more of a power style when he came into WWE, but...
I mean, when he was in IWA Mid-South, he would take bumps to the concrete. I mean, I know all that stuff, but...
Yeah, I mean, when he was younger, but he might, you know, he probably... If he kept going, I mean, he's beat up. And I'll tell you what, I know you don't like the guy, but John Cena may end up being in a wheelchair, too, the way he's going.
I don't know.
Do you know how beat up that motherfucker is?
I bet, man. He's. I mean, I'll give him that, man. I mean, work ethics, dude. I mean, his dedication to his job is tremendous. It's crazy. But still not a fan of the guy. But hey, I'll tell you one thing though. You really, really commend. I mean, I salute him for what he does for the fucking. The Make-A-Wish Foundation. I think that's awesome. But other than that, dude, I don't care about the guy.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty cool to, like, you know. Because, you know, like, when you think about that, like, a lot of people just hear that, but they don't put it in perspective and actually put themselves in the guy's shoe. Just imagine every – I mean, he's the most – and this is – how ironic is this that I'm actually putting over Cena on the show? Holy shit. I believe this is happening. Maybe I should stop.
Whoa.
Fuck. Oh, no. God damn it. Fuck.
Putting over Cena, everybody. He's going to put him over. Hold on.
not letting me do it, man. But fuck. Jeez. All right. But honestly, imagine being this guy.
You're gonna do it. No.
I'll do it.
You don't have to.
I'll do it. I mean, it's deserved in this portion of his career. Anyway, not the in ring wrestling portion, the outside of the ring charity portion of his career is good stuff. Anyway, just imagine being this guy, right? Tired and beat up from the road, and you're the most wanted Make-A-Wish Foundation guy, right? So just imagine how depressing that is to go and see all these kids that you know that are going to pass away soon, right? That shit's going to get to you, dude. I don't care who you are. That shit is going to get to you, you know? Especially when it becomes a pattern, almost a weekly pattern, that's going to tear you down, you know, mentally, man. I don't care what you say. That's why people say Cena's a fucking robot. Look at the guy. He's emotionless.
Yeah?
Look at him. He's a fucking robot.
I've seen him.
They boo the shit out of this guy. He comes out and he winks at the camera. I don't give a shit.
Oh, when he talks to that goddamn
camera. Oh, I hate that. Oh, dude, that is the biggest douchebag thing to do. He comes out. Oh, do you hear that crowd? No, motherfucker, I can't hear them. What do you think, man? Of course I can hear them.
I agree with him.
Question is that. Don't ask rhetorical questions to the camera when you're fucking coming out and making an entrance. And you see how quickly that flipped from me putting him over to just shitting on him? Wow, that's why I don't like this guy, clearly. I try to put him over, and nope, can't happen. Son of a bitch.
It's funny.
God damn.
Man.
Back to Raw, I guess.
Well, if we're going to Raw, where are we now? All right, we're already past that. We're at Brie Bella versus Paige.
Give it to me.
Oh, hold on. I was moving some stuff around here. Here you go. There you go.
Three in a row.
Yeah. Okay, so let's do that. Brie wins the match. Brie, of course, distraction, roll up, you know, usual WWE. And then WWE finally announces the first inductee into the WWE Hall of Fame, and it is a good one. I think we all agree with it.
Absolutely.
That's right.
Ooh, yeah.
So we don't want to get kicked off YouTube.
Ooh, yeah, nigga. Yeah.
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 Ooh,
the Macho Man. That guy is awesome.
Accepted. Thank you. Thank you, Macho Man. Glad you accept
my opinion. You know what, Boxman? We should go ahead and slap ourselves. You know why?
Why?
We forgot to mention the Macho Man Randy Savage on our top 10 wrestlers.
Well,
we did, didn't we? We both forgot him, I think.
Yeah, probably.
Honestly, I would put him right there, like number 2 for me, probably. Or maybe even number 1. Shit, I can't really even say somebody better than him overall.
Man, I don't know if he'd be on my list.
Oh, he has to be either number 2 or number 1 for me, man.
I mean, don't get me wrong. The guy is great. I'm not saying he's not. But, yeah, I just don't know. I mean, he maybe he would. I don't know.
If I ever got any wrestling-related tattoos, it'd probably be Macho Man, Ultimate Warrior, or ECW if ECW was still alive. I would never get it now. But Macho Man and Ultimate Warrior, those two are probably the only ones that I would ever get.
Yes, yeah, I would get the Warrior mask on my, and I actually thought about it a few times.
Yeah, I'm probably going to end up getting that sometime before I
die. I'm definitely thinking, oh, dude, we should both get them.
Oh, dude, man, like, totally high-tech podcast.
We put the hot tag right in the middle. Oh,
get like a hot tag tattoo, man. Sounds pretty gay.
Alright, that'd be kind of... Let's not do that. That'd be gay. Anyway, we'd be walking down the street, show each other our tattoos, all we hear is...
Oh, those guys are fast!
I knew that was coming.
Oh, man.
But,
we only have 38 sounds on here. I'm going to use them more than once.
There you go, man. Next, we got the Ascension. Oh, well, let's talk about Savage for a second. Also got the news that Hulk Hogan is going to be inducting him. Please, I'm going to put myself on mute for a minute because I got to let these dogs out. Go ahead and express your feelings. I'm sure you at least have a minute or two to talk about this because this is kind of makes sense, but it's weird.
It does make sense, but with all the heat that they've been through, go ahead and do what you got to do. Some of the heat they've been through, it is kind of weird that they're just kind of letting Hogan do it, but I don't know. I mean, I guess when you go back to that era, there's no one else really that you can pick that would be more fitting than Hogan. Let's face it, when they were, you know, when the NWO started, that's where, you know, I mean, he came down and attacked Randy. So, you know, I mean, that was, I mean, talk about historic, that was it. So I don't see how, you know, you could really take anyone else from the, you know, the late 80s to 90s era and pick anyone else that would actually make sense to induct him in, even though they did have some heat. You know, and Hogan says they spoke at the end. I don't know. Hogan's kind of hard to believe sometimes, as much as I love the guy. You know, but I don't know. Definitely not a bad thing. Hogan will more than likely do just fine. I don't see where it's going to be bad. But, yeah, I just don't see where anyone else could really fit. You're not going to have Vince do it. That would just be creepy and weird. Everybody would bitch. Lanny could do it. I'm sure there was probably mention of him doing it. But I don't know. And like someone in the chat room just said, I hope Lanny will be accepting also. Has something to say, but I don't know what's going to happen there. I'm just really happy they are putting Macho Man into the Hall of Fame. It's time. Let's face it, the guy should have been in there a long time ago. So, but I got no problem with Hogan doing it. I was saying that, yeah, I think Hogan, when you think about the era, there's really no one else. I mean, Hogan's done a lot of history with Randy Macho Man, you know, Savage, especially the NWO, who was the first person he attacked in turn. Neil?
Yeah, so. Absolutely, man. Even the Mega Powers. I mean, yeah. WrestleMania, main events, everything.
Yeah, there's a lot of history there. And, you know, I know they had some heat. Hogan said he had squashed it with them.
Ah, bullshit.
I'm glad you said that, because I said, you know.
Bullshit, man. He always does that. Yeah, fuck.
I know. Are you surprised Lanny isn't accepting? Or I'm sorry, inducting? Blah, I can't speak.
Well, I'm kind of surprised, but like you said, you were mistakenly saying that he's going to be accepting, but I'm hoping that he's at least going to be accepting.
I hope so, too. That was actually Body in the chat room saying he hopes it, too. I totally agree. I don't see how you couldn't have him accept. I mean, what, are you going to just have Hogan come up there and talk?
No, definitely. Hogan is probably going to be presenting him, and Lanny's probably going to be accepting it. But it is really weird, man. I mean, I definitely think there was still heat. I don't believe Hogan. I mean, fucking Randy Savage almost dedicated a whole CD dissing the guy.
Yeah. Maybe Stephanie will come up and accept.
I mean, that would be a slap to the face, man.
Is that too early? Should I not have done that? Get it? Accept?
Oh, shit. I didn't even think about... I didn't know. That's a good one.
Oh!
I like that. That was good. That was a good one. I like that one, though. That whole thing that Ambrose did, that was cool, man. I like that. That was like a throwback.
That was kind of funny. I
like that. Yeah, I like how the crowd picked it up. But do you see that, though? They actually do something that worked, and you see how quickly the crowd picked it up and ran with it?
Yeah, they did.
Now, I guarantee you, mark my word, that's going to be the new thing. The whole thing, they're going to be doing it next week.
They will. That was some old school Jericho shit right there.
Exactly, dude. It's like Attitude Era type shit. That's why it worked. That's why the crowds were so hot, because they gave them shit to actually want to get invested in and want to actually chant and et cetera, you know? I mean, who wants to scream, believe that? What?
Not me, bro.
Yeah, not me, bro. No.
Not me, bro.
Believe that and never give up. I mean, these aren't things people want to scream. Like, you know, hell yeah, that's catchy. That's why people said it, you know? And that's the bottom line.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. And that's the bottom line. Ric Flair, woo, you know, it's all catchy shit. Nowadays, John Cena.
316 says I just whipped your ass.
There you go, man. Nowadays, the catchphrase is.
Oh, be sexy.
I know that one.
Nowadays, the catchphrase is, you know, there's none.
That one's gone.
So.
All right, 37. All right. Yeah. But, yeah, it was funny. I thought it was kind of some old Jericho shit.
Yeah, I really liked it. I thought that was pretty good. Actually, I liked Ambrose. I think he was probably one of the best parts of the night.
Yeah, I think so too. And he kind of ended up, you know, co-main eventing. All right, have we talked enough about Randy and everything, or do you want to keep going with it?
No. I mean, one thing I'll say is if the Warrior was alive, I think he'd be presenting him.
Could be. That could be one too. That would be the only other person I could think of to fit in with that era, I guess. You know, even though Warrior wasn't around as long as Macho, but
I mean, Warrior really liked him. He's the one guy that he actually liked.
Yeah, yeah. They from the stories he told, they seemed to get along very good.
Right. So that's unfortunate, man. Two of my favorite wrestlers, you know, both gone. But that's the wrestling business.
That's it, man. Go ahead with the next one.
All right, next one we got the Ascension against Jobbers, which the Jobbers were actually from Luke Hawk's. What is it? Wildcats.
Wildcat. Yeah. Well, with a K.
There you go, Wildcat. So check them out, Luke Hawk's, man. He's fucking awesome.
Luke Hawk's. Yep, out in that place is out in. Where is that one? I know it's in New Orleans.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure exactly where, but yeah. New Orleans.
New Orleans, man. Gucci Mane coming out of New Orleans and shit, man. Hanging out with Lou Hawks, man. We just hanging and banging, eating some chicken wings. Ain't nothing but a thing, man. We just smoking on them goddamn blunts out here, drinking all them 40s and shit, man. Barbecuing with these big-ass booty bitches out here, man. Gucci Mane with my chain hanging low down on my dick.
There you go. Smoke weed every day.
Gucci Mane do that too, man. Gucci Mane co-sign that shit, man.
All right. We were saying that Wildcat is in Kenner, out in Nolens, I guess.
Nolens.
I don't know, man. I wish that shit wasn't 8 hours away, because I would go in a minute.
New Orleans, Louisiana.
Go in a minute to go see that Wildcat wrestling. But I'll tell you what was funny about those jobbers. When the Ascension threw that little dude up in the air, he screamed like a little girl.
Yeah, actually, I've seen that little dude live. It's funny he was on there. He was actually at the first, not the first, the second Extreme Rising.
Really? He screamed like a little girl when they threw him in the air. He was like, ah!
It's funny, because I knew the one guy, the Persian guy, Pervez Memori. He was a jobber on the first debut match of the Ascension, and this one is the other guy from Extreme Rising, so that's weird.
Nice, man.
I've seen all the jobbers. That's awesome.
Nice. There you go. You're a jobber knowing person. Awesome. Yeah. You got anything to say about this match except for how bad the Ascension is?
No, but I like that. I like how they threw him up in the air, and I kind of like their finishing move. It kind of reminds me of the Eliminators, except like not nearly as good, because I actually think Eliminators are probably one of the better tag teams of the 90s that are really underrated, because obviously because their careers were short lived, but they remind me of the Eliminators, just a poor man's version.
If you say so, man. If you say so.
They don't?
I don't know, man. They're just
so... They have the same fucking outfits. They have the same hair. I mean, I'm talking about the Eliminators in like 94, 95 when they first came in ECW. It's like the same shit.
Guys are just so annoying. I just think they came out again and, you know, they had a little cut, cut in promo, and they again dissed Demolition and... Man, I wish Demolition would run in from the audience and beat their ass. Much as I
realize that Demolition are like 75.
Yeah, next thing you know, they're gonna start talking shit about the Rock and Roll Express.
Nah, they're not big enough.
Fuck that. What am I? Don't be talking no shit about the Rock and Roll Express. You get fucked up, man.
I'm just stating facts, man. I'm just spitting facts.
Nah, he ain't. No facts.
It's been motherfucking facts, man.
Rock and Roll Express, some bad motherfuckers.
Man, them boys are little, man.
Fuck that.
Man, some little boys, man.
Fuck that.
It's so weird how they look the same. Look exactly the same as they did in the 80s.
Fuck that, bro. Ricky Morton with the hair. They're fucking all gray now and so fucking long, bro. Shit, bro.
I can't believe they used to be sex symbols, man. These fucking guys.
Jim Cornette said fucking Ricky almost basically had sex on the way to the ring. Girls were grabbing his dick.
Why? Odd looking dude. Man.
A lot of coke in the 80s, bro. A lot of coke in the 80s, man.
I bet.
Them girls didn't see shit but money and dick. That was it.
Money, dick, and cocaine.
Yeah, you got money, dick, hair, and you got long hair. You could glam rock. Like, fuck yeah. That was all you needed back then. You didn't even need the money. If you had coke and long hair in the 80s, you were a fucking pimp.
All the bitches from the 80s, they just wanted cocaine and dick.
That's all they wanted. Coke and dick. You didn't even have to have the money. If you had the coke, you had the money. That was fine.
Dick. They just like slap the dick on a plate and pour some coke on it, let them smoke it off.
I don't know, man. But just imagine you're running to the ring. You're pulling women's fucking hands out of your pants. I'd never make it to the ring.
Yeah.
I'd just be sitting there like, oh, who's next?
Hopefully not that fast.
I would have coined Goldberg's phrase before he did.
Oh, man. But yeah. Next we had Rusev and Ambrose, which I enjoyed this. Again, it was really short. But the ending was just like, you know, these fuck finishes, dude. They have to stop this.
They're fuck finishes.
Fuck finishes are terrible. The ref stops the match because his Ambrose like leg hurts. Like what? When has this ever happened before? What is he, Sin Cara?
I don't know. I wish someone had brought up the footage of Triple H being put in the walls of Jericho with a torn fucking quad.
Exactly. Man up.
Goddamn Stone Cold rolling up Owen with God, you know, with a complete stinger in his body, can't even move. Yeah. Let's call the match because his widow knee hurts. Aw, poor baby. Oh, can I get you some ice?
And keep in mind, he's not actually injured, so this was an angle, which is even worse because it just shows that they're just being lazy. He just couldn't come up with anything, so they were like, just work his leg the whole match, and we'll just stop the match like 4 minutes into it.
Gotta make Rusev look strong, man. Gotta make Rusev look strong.
Yeah, but if you're gonna make him look strong, why make Ambrose look weak? And I know they didn't really make him look weak since he didn't quit. The ref did it on his own. But still, just like he just came off what, 12 losses from Wyatt?
I don't know. They probably should have had Ambrose hit him with a chair, get the DQ. That's what I would have done because, you know, Ambrose is the, you know, they're kind of making him, obviously he's the, I really hate to say this, but he's basically the new Brian Pillman. I hate to say it. I hate saying the new anything, but really that's what they're trying to make him is Pillman. This isn't the kind of ending that you would have seen out of any match like that. He should have come in with a chair or something, hit him. Because I heard, and here you go. You know who attacked him after the show, right? After the show was completely over.
No.
They said Bray Wyatt came out and attacked him. So
attacked Ambrose?
Yeah.
Wow, but that's still not finished?
Wyatt, right, he said it was.
Yeah. You gotta stop, man. I've had enough.
I have too. I agree.
I really like both guys, so I mean.
Exactly, but enough. Let's get some fresh matchups. You've got these guys. Let them. Whoa. Just get some fresh matchups, man. I just want to see some.
And they've done literally every gimmick match like possible. So yes. Where do they go from here?
They have. So
stop while you're ahead, WWE. Stop while you're ahead.
Yeah, but yeah, I would have had Ambrose come in, slap him with a chair. You want to make Rusev look strong? Have him no-sell the chair shot.
Yeah.
And come right back at Ambrose and take him down. Boom. Match is over. Both your guys look strong.
You want to make both of them look strong, just have both of them brawl back to backstage.
Count out.
That's it.
Count out.
Yep, there you go. Finished. Simple as that.
Look at that. We got two different ways right now they could have ended that match, but...
There you go. But no, he had a hurt leg.
Yeah. His little knee hurt. I'm going to get you some iron.
He has weak calves. He doesn't work them out enough.
Do you want a boo-boo, buddy?
Ambles. Little Dean Ambles.
I got a boo-boo buddy in the freezer for my little boy. Would you like one, too?
Huh? I wonder how Songman says Dean Ambrose. How do you think he pronounces that?
Diablos.
Yeah. I have a feeling he says Dwayne. You don't think so?
Dwayne? Maybe.
Yeah. Dwayne Ambrose.
I don't know. For some reason, they all call Daniel Bryan Daniel Bryant.
Yeah.
With the T. But anyway.
Can we start one of those Kickstarters to do a fucking Songman documentary? I need this in my life.
I already told you the movie I got in my head. I think it would be a fucking award-winning movie.
Dude, I need this in my life. Let's make this happen.
I'm telling you, man, I got the movie in my head. I've got it. I've got the whole thing. I'm telling you.
But I need reality, though. I want to see this guy on his...
This basically would be. We can collaborate with him.
Well, let's make this happen.
So when you walked in her house... What did she say? That's what she said? And she didn't call the cops? Really? Okay. Anyway, let's keep going. All right.
Man.
Telling you, I've got a movie. I got it. It could be it could make millions.
Do you think he's still a virgin?
Oh, now you're asking questions I don't want to answer, but the answer would be hell yeah. Wait. The answer would be,
Oh, hell yeah. I mean, it is 2015, though, dude. I don't know, man. And he's just, like, jacking off to, like, 3D puzzles? Or?
I don't even think he is.
he doesn't jack off at all?
I just think it's there, just kind of rotting away.
It just hangs out there. His dick never ejaculates. It just hangs out in his tight way.
Sitting there rotting the fuck away, waiting for some probably hospital nurse to molest. Oh, I'm getting bad. Can we stop this?
Oh, man. Yeah.
All right. God damn it. We need to...
This is your main event of the evening.
All right. Main event. Let's do this before the FCC takes us down.
Yeah. They would never do that.
They'd probably do it for the picture in the chat room right now. God damn, what the fuck?
Well, let me get in there.
Let's say Club Gape or Vape. What the fuck?
Whoa. What happened? I
love our chat room. I do. Oh, that's funny. There's Shaheen. Whoa. I'm not saying hi to you. So, all right, we get into this main event. Our main event, again, was a contract signing.
With, I actually like this, man. Everybody hated it. I liked it.
Yeah, I thought it was a pretty good show, a good ending. Obviously, it you know, made everyone look strong, which is what WWE is all about lately.
But more importantly, it actually made me a little bit excited about this match.
This match, yes, but the rest of the Rumble...
Yeah.
I mean, we've only got, what, 3 entrants into the Rumble? Dean?
No, we got a bunch now, actually.
Who?
Got like 6.
Oh. Ooh. Ooh. I'm sorry. We're a whole week away, and there's 6 total so far. Awesome.
I can name like 25 of the people that are going to be there.
Oh, dude, I know who we're going to... You mean in the match?
Yeah.
Oh, I know who's going to be in it. It's going to be the fucking the whole roster they push. I mean, that's going to be it.
All right. Well, let's do this. Let's come up with a group of talent that are going to show up at fucking Royal Rumble.
Okay. New Day.
So that's 3.
Cesaro.
4.
Kid. Tyson Kidd.
Right.
Rusev will be in. Oh, no. Does Rusev have a match?
No, he'll be in
it. He'll be in it. Ambrose announced he was in it.
Right.
You know the Ascension's going to be in it.
Reigns.
Usos, unless they have a match.
Honestly, I don't think Usos or the Ascension will be in there. You think the Ascension's going to be in there?
Yeah, I think they'll be in there. Yeah, I do.
I don't think they should put tag teams in there, man.
They shouldn't, but they do.
Pointless.
They do all the time. They'll probably throw...
Is it Mizdow?
Mizdow and Miz. I don't know. Okay. See, we don't know who's going to... I mean, there may still be a couple other matches on that card, and I don't know who they are yet, so...
But you I know, mean, they'll show up in the match, though.
You know Ryback and... Oh, and Rowan and Ziggler are going to be there. Don't fool yourselves, people.
Right.
It's going to be the usual. It's going to be everyone that you see on TV for the past year. Titus O'Neil will run in, and maybe they'll probably. I wouldn't doubt if they threw in a girl.
Well, that'd be weird.
Yeah, they don't really have any jacked up chicks anymore. They should have kept that big Aloisa girl.
Or just bring back. I was gonna say King Kong. What's her name?
Yeah, they're not bringing back Awesome Kong.
Yeah.
She has signed. I don't know. Bring back Nicole Bass. She'd be happy to do something. Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Ooh. God. Ooh.
Man. God. Damn, that's a huge bitch.
She always reminded me of Herman Munster. Just a big, crazy chick. But, main event, we had a wonderful, wonderful signing, contract signing. I don't understand. I thought this was going to go without a hitch. I thought there was going to be no fight. Man.
Yeah. Usual, right?
I mean, don't they always go like that? Man.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
But this all happened. There was a bunch of talking, and I gotta admit, dude, I started playing Uno on my phone around this time.
Yeah.
And I looked up when they started brawling, and
I actually like this, man. Basically, they were trying to align with each other as far as I think it was Brock and Rollins, and at first it was Cena and Brock, and Cena was trying to get Brock to align himself with him and just take out Rollins, and then they'll face off. And Cena will kick his ass.
Yeah.
And the other option was for Seth Rollins and Brock Lesnar to align and take out fuckboy Cena. So, at the end, basically, they all just started brawling. You know, we got an AA through the table, which was cool, I guess. Well, John Cena, learn how to take a curb stomp, dude. You've taken about 300 of them. All good, man. John Cena should be sorry for taking that fucking terrible curb stomp. This guy's been taking them at house shows. He's been taking them on a nightly basis. I mean, come on, man. Did you see that?
Yeah, and by the way, way to sell that German suplex, John Cena.
Yeah, terrible, dude. That sucks.
Like a half a second later, he jumps up like nothing happened.
Well, it's because he takes 16 of them, so.
Yeah.
Whatever. But I don't know, man. That curb stomp was terrible. And then on the other hand, you saw Brock?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, dude. That looked like it hurt.
Yeah, he put his head into the fucking mat.
He ate the carpet.
He did, man. He took that pretty goddamn good.
Did you see this? His forehead? It was all burned, dude. I mean, it was all brush burn, man. So, he's fucked. That's gonna stink for a couple days.
Yeah, that'll leave a nice little raspberry.
Yeah. But that was Raw, man. One thing I forgot to mention that I found hilarious was the in the Cena and Seth Rollins match, there was a spot where John Cena got on the top rope and he jumped onto the lumberjacks. Now, as he was about to leap onto the jungle jacks, I don't know why. As he was about to leap onto the lumberjacks, you see Bad News Barrett in the corner, and he's just wandering off in the corner somewhere. And he notices, hey, maybe I should be with a group over here so I can do this spot, and I don't look like an idiot when everybody else is down. So he runs to this. Did you see this?
Mm-hmm.
Was that a yes or no?
No.
Oh, my God. How did you miss this, man? It was the funniest part of the night. Dude, John Cena, like, literally, he was in the air, and you just see Barrett run and try to, like, catch him.
I'm sorry, you locked up for half a second. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was going to say, when you see, like, John Cena, he jumped off, right? And you just see Barrett just run to the group of the heels that are about to, essentially just catch this guy. And he basically just jumps in there to catch John Cena, and then he just goes down and pretends like he's hurt. So it was hilarious.
I'm going to have to check this out, definitely.
Yeah, anybody listening right now, check this out. It's funny as shit.
Yeah, I'm going to have to check that out.
There you go.
There we go.
From next week, hopefully we're going to be doing like a segment a week where we go over a shoot interview or some kind of DVD that we both have and watch. So, Boxman.
Yeah, I was going to ask you which one you wanted to do.
Doesn't matter. Do you have any?
We'll go over during the week because I've got them all at home. I can't look from here.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll figure something out, and then next week we'll review one and we'll kind of break it down for you. And, you know, if there's anything, you know, get some kind of good discussion going on. Should be good shit.
Yeah, they're in there talking about shooting interviews anyways, so.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at, so it kind of reminded me of our conversation.
Yeah.
Does Triple H speak like that in like a normal conversation?
No.
We're about to go, it's over there.
Funny, I was listening to Opie and Anthony today, and on their, they have a podcast too, and they had CM Punk and Mick Foley on. Not at the same time, but on both. And in both interviews, they were talking about how they can't stand the suit Triple H. He comes in there now, and he's all stiff and stuffy, and they're like, man, he used to come in here and spank naked asses on chicks named Peaches. Now yeah. He comes in here, and he won't even do anything.
Yeah, now he just, like, drinks water and eats apples and fucking does all that good shit, you know?
Those workout videos.
He does workout videos. He kisses babies. He does corporate stuff. He buys and sells stock. All that good stuff, you know?
Yeah. So, do you want to get into
Lucha Underground?
Woo, woo, woo. Lucha!
Now, I must admit, when I first was listening to the idea, but what read what this show was about, I wasn't too happy. I was thinking this is probably a bad time to do this for your show. You're kind of still new. You don't want to do a one thing like this, one match. But this might have been one of the best hours of TV I've ever watched with one match.
I fucking loved it, man. It was the first show that I actually watched on my television. So
nice.
Thank you to Unimas.
Nice.
Network, whatever you want to call it. I thought it was awesome, man. This wasn't your typical battle royal.
No. First of all, over the rope didn't mean shit. You had to either submit or pin your opponent.
Yep.
So that made it different right there. So, I think they knew this was going to be close to the Royal Rumble, and they didn't want to be seen as doing a copy. They've got enough ex-WWE guys in there to know that, so.
Yeah, definitely. I loved every minute of it, man. I thought it was really good stuff. Yeah. I pretty much like them all, man. Drago, what's the other guy's name? Phoenix, Octagon Jr., Pentagon Jr., whatever his name is.
Yeah, that's
Yeah, they're all awesome, man.
Yeah, it started off with Johnny Mundo and Johnny Morrison and Phoenix, which, goddamn, those two are fucking good, man.
Oh yeah. Actually, this week coming up, it's gonna be Prince Puma against Phoenix, and I am looking forward to that match.
Mm-hmm. I am too. I saw that match was coming up, and I am definitely looking forward to that match too.
You're advertising it as a match straight out of a video game, so that should be exciting.
Nice. Yeah, I saw that on Facebook.
Yeah.
I did see that on Facebook. So yeah, that definitely. Yeah, that's gonna be a badass match right there. But yeah, this was just amazing. How they did this show. I just thought it was, I really was very worried. I'm like, oh my God, one match for a whole TV show? This is going to suck.
Yeah.
At the end of it, it was like, God damn, that was the whole show? That was an hour?
Yeah, it was definitely good, man.
Felt like 10 fucking minutes.
Yeah, I was satisfied with my wrestling for the week.
Absolutely. I mean, you had everybody in that match. You had the Pimpinella came in, the Superfly came down, Chavo, Pentagon, you said, Sexy Star. God, she's hot.
The Drag Queen.
Pimpinella.
There you go. The Midget.
Big Rick,
yes, sir. The Midget and...
Yep. Mil Muertes. And, it gets down to it, and it came down to basically the two guys that started. It came down to, came down to John Morrison and,
Yeah, Puma.
Puma, yeah, it came down to the first two guys.
Yeah. And Puma.
Damn, they had a good ending, good match, and I think they put the belt on the right guy. That belt's not good looking at all, though.
Yeah, it didn't really stand out to me, but. It looks like it's heavy. I like that.
It does. It looks heavy. It's not a horrible looking belt, but it's not horrible. It's not good.
The WWE belt, man, it looks like it's fucking like made out of like tinfoil, you know? It's like I like that it looks heavy. It looks like legit steel, you know?
Yeah.
Well, not steel, gold, whatever.
Right. There, yeah, gold. But I don't know, man. I just thought this was a perfect person to put the belt on at this point. If you had to put it on anyone, it had to go on either those two or Chavo. And I'm kind of glad they didn't put it on Chavo. I think that would have been kind of internet ex-WWE, WWE castaway bullshit. You know, you would have heard all this shit from the internet. So good idea putting it on one of your guys. And Johnny Mundo is probably going to chase it, which I think will be good.
Yeah, but Chavo kind of sucks anyway.
I think he's amazing on this show, dude. I really do. I think this is his niche or something, because he's like a different person on this goddamn show.
Yeah. I mean, he's certainly better, but
I don't know if it's the not scripted or if he can be himself or what, but something here has him in a much better place than he ever was in WCW or WWE, in my opinion.
Probably a combination of both.
And, I mean, TNA, I'm not even going to bring up.
Yeah.
Yeah, he gave up in TNA before he started, it looked like.
That's the case with everybody, man. I mean, look at Van Damme. Van Damme barely gave a shit.
I'll say it again. I swear to God, I think Van Damme was fine until he knocked out Abyss's teeth. I'm telling you, that fucked him up mentally in some way.
Yeah, I don't remember that, so.
Oh.
I gotta check it out.
And I'll find it, and I'll drop it on the old drive. Yeah. He threw one of those spinning back kicks and nailed him, right, and knocked two of his teeth out.
Yeah.
Those two bottom teeth that he is missing?
Right.
RVD.
Is it a Stairway to Janus?
Might have been that Stairway to Janus match, that first one.
There's a bunch. I don't know which
one. Yeah, it might have been that Stairway to Janus match. It might be back on YouTube now. They might have taken it down for a while, but I don't check YouTube that much. Once I don't find it, I just move on to the next bullshit.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed Lucha Underground, and I really did not think I was going to. So I was very satisfied.
Yes, sir. It was definitely good, man. I loved it.
Do you think they're gonna have some? I mean, are do you think they're going to put some God damn it. Do you think they're going to put some different title? Are they going to have a tag title? Are they going to have a women's title?
Eventually, I think so. I think they're just trying to feel it out, man.
Huh.
You know?
Yeah, maybe.
Eventually they will. I'm sure they will eventually.
I guess we'll figure it out. But yeah, I definitely... definitely wouldn't mind seeing at least some tag titles. I don't think they need a women's title because the women go in the ring against the men.
Oh, my God, man. I love wrestling fans.
Are you watching them? No. Look at the pictures again.
No. I just saw somebody post something up on one of these forums. All it says is, "Wrestling does not change. The fans do." By Anonymous. And ooh, it's like quoted by Anonymous.
Ooh, that's deep.
It's deep, it is. And it's written to be like so. There's like fucking all these comments of people like agreeing with it and shit. It's crazy. Oh my God, man.
Oh, wow. That's
craziness. You're fucking nuts.
That's amazing right there, man.
"Wrestling doesn't change. The fans do." What do you mean wrestling doesn't change? What the fuck does that mean? It's changed from last year. I mean...
oh, yeah.
What are you talking about, dude? I don't know what you're watching.
Something.
The same shit that I'm watching. Maybe he's like kind of slow, and he's been watching the same match on rewind for the last like 20 years.
Maybe there you go.
Maybe that's the case.
Anything's possible with all the drugs out there. and that's what I'm saying, you know, drugs, man. Fucking drugs.
There you go.
There you go.
Anything else you want to talk about before we get out of here?
Short. I think we got a little bit of news we can get into. Looks like I don't know if you noticed it, but it looks like WWE is definitely getting ready to split up Miz and Mizdow, which I'm not sure is going to be good or bad. I think it's going to be good. I think it's going to be good for Mizdow.
Right.
I think he's ready. The crowd is behind him. If they wait any longer, you and I both know what's going to happen. The crowd is going to start turning on him, and it won't matter.
Absolutely. How do you? What makes you think they're going to split them up?
Dave Meltzer said it.
Oh, fact.
Fact. Meltzer said it, and he has a microphone. Fact.
Have you seen this? There's a Twitter handle. I think it's called Dave Meltzer in the 90s. Are you familiar with this one?
It should just say Dave Meltzer.
It's amazing.
That's all it should say.
It's so good, man.
Is it?
It's amazing. And all it is it just takes direct quotes from Dave Meltzer in the 90s.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so funny how many of them are just incorrect and just fucking stupid. It's just amazing. Check it out, people. Just type in Dave Meltzer on Twitter. You'll find it. It's amazing.
Oh, jeez. That does sound funny.
It makes my day.
It makes your day. That's great.
First thing, I wake up in the morning, so I brush my teeth, walk my dogs, I go to take my shit, check my Facebook, then I go on Dave Meltzer from the 90s to get a good laughter.
Today, January 13th, they're saying... Someone's saying the WWE Network is already available in the UK and Ireland ahead of the January 19th launch date.
Oh, shit.
I don't know if that's true. I guess we'll see.
Yeah, well, it doesn't really pertain to us.
No, but that would be cool. Yeah. But that would be good for them at least. Let's see here. What else do we got?
Got
who?
Ryback.
What about him?
Well, he's trying to make it look like he's going to show up on TNA.
Oh, yeah. You were saying that. You got that in front of you?
Yeah, he just posted up a picture of his new graffiti fucking airbrush Terminator boots. And it says, I wonder what channel these boots are going to debut on. So.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of clever, though. I mean, I'd rather have this than just nothing.
They're going to be deleting that tweet.
Yeah, it's probably deleted by now.
I'm sure.
They should just send them to these little, like, indie events. Why not? Honestly, why not? I mean, I'm not saying send them to TNA or Ring of Honor. Like, literally, these smaller shows, like Pro Wrestling Syndicate, why not just send the guy there? Have a working relationship.
I agree. I agree.
You know?
Yep. You're not
gonna lose any fans to a show that's drawn, like, at tops, like, 1,000 fans. I mean, come on, dude. But then that footage will get on YouTube, it'll go viral, and people will actually get invested in them and believe in it, you know? And so what? You'll create a couple thousand fans for PWS or whatever indie show wants to do this, you know? Like, who gives a shit, man?
Yeah, exactly. Who cares? It's
fucking petty and egotistical that you guys can't work with anybody, you know what I mean? I'm not saying go and have the guys go on Impact, but I don't know.
Wouldn't bother me.
I think it'd be cool.
I mean, I know they wouldn't, and you know that's fine. Right. I don't care about it, but I don't know, man. Just let it slide.
I know Body is saying Ryback's messing with the Marks. Indeed, he is, man. That's why I like him. It's funny.
Ryback's been going to the Jericho school of Mark Ribbon.
There you go, man. I like how Ryback is actually a fan of wrestling, though. You know,
if you listen to his to that podcast on Jericho, that dude, and I think I might have said this Saturday. If I did, I'm sorry. That dude is a passionate wrestling fan. He loves what he does. He loves the business of wrestling. How can you not just appreciate that now?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, especially with, you know, what you hear about all these wrestlers now, that they're all just in it for the money and that's it. You got to appreciate it, and I did.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Anything else on here?
I'm thinking, man. You got anything else, or you want to get this done this early?
Well, I do have to get up early in the morning, and we did just do like a 3-hour show like 2 nights ago.
2 hours and 59 minutes, sir.
All right. Well, damn it.
Let's not exaggerate, Shaheen.
Nah, whatever, man.
God. Give you an inch, you'll take a mile. Motherfucker.
Oh, man. What the fuck is... Yeah, I don't really see much else on here, man.
Give you a rope, you want to be a cowboy. Man.
I'm a cowboy! Hulk Hogan says he talked to Randy Savage's brother.
Yeah, I saw that. It says he talked to Lanny, blah, blah, blah. The whole family's okay with the arrangement.
Oh, cool. See, look at this. Look at this. Things are exactly the way he wants them for the Poffo family. Get the fuck out of here, Hogan. Come on, man. This guy has publicly said the only way he wanted, you know, to be inducted is with his family. So clearly it's not exactly how they wanted it, you dickhead. You don't have to be... Oh, this is Hogan. This is typical Hogan for you right here.
Like I said, man, Hogan's really hard to believe lately.
That's Hogan right here. Hogan.
The internet exposed Hogan for a liar.
Oh, yeah. This guy's something else, man.
Yeah. I don't really think Hogan's telling the truth all the time, but...
I don't think he's ever telling the truth. Hogan says to him, do the opposite.
I think every now and then he's telling the truth, but you know, you gotta dig through. You gotta dig through the shit to get to the truth. So, you know, you gotta dig.
True. Well, look here. Why WWE Network is unable to air Main Event? Apparently, Main Event is no longer on the WWE Network. Oh, I didn't know that.
If the excuse is just because it sucks, I am so behind it.
Yeah, same.
Tell us, Shaheen. You can't do that and not tell us. You got to tell us. Come on, Shaheen. Tell us.
Do you really want to know? All right. As noted, WWE Network will not air a new episode of Main Event next Tuesday night, and Santino Marella's Royal Rumble Lottery Special will air instead. So I guess it's not going to be all forever. It's just next week. So Santino Marella's Royal fucking Rumble Lottery Special. Blah.
Wow.
Off, dude. Nobody...
I wish I could take that drum roll back now.
Yeah, I wish you could.
But it's already recorded. Nothing I can do.
Dude, let's just erase this whole episode for that.
No, that would mean... We already did enough of that. The funny thing is, I know it says we're only on the 27th episode. This is probably like the 30 or 31st. We just forgot to record like 3 or 4 of them.
True, that is true. You're an ass.
I forgot to record them.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. He's publicly admitting that he's an asshole.
Dude, I've been admitting that since I was 16 years old.
There you go, man.
I got no problem. You can call me an asshole all day. Sticks and stones, motherfucker.
By the way, ECW Zombie, he has passed away, so rest in peace to him.
Yeah, I saw that, man. Has anything come out saying what from yet?
No, he passed away in his sleep. So I don't. They said they don't think it was like drug related or anything, so that's good. But I don't know. And also, what's his name? Jason Knight from ECW fame. He has advanced throat cancer, which is not. Yeah.
Man, I saw that. That sucks. I actually knew a guy. Right when I moved here, about a year later, he ended up having advanced stage 4 throat cancer.
Yeah.
He didn't make it long, but he also never stopped drinking liquor and smoking cigars.
Yeah.
So, you know, let's hope Jason does and can get better.
Absolutely.
Lay off the liquor and cigars, man.
Yeah. So I guess we can't leave off on that note. Jesus Christ.
No, we can talk about
I am hungry. I want to get out of here. I just don't.
All right, well, real quick.
Don't want to leave off on that throat cancer note. So that's kind of depressing.
What do you got? There's got to be something we can leave. Hold on. Go to the Facebook.
Goddamn news, motherfucker. I can't find shit.
Go to the Facebook, Shaheen. You got to go to the Facebook, man.
All right. Well, how about you go to the Facebook? I keep checking on the news over here.
There's something on our thing on the Facebook. Is there anything on the Facebook that we can find?
Well, Jeff Hardy.
Took a bomb?
And spoiler alert. If you didn't know, which I'm sure everybody knows by now, Jeff Hardy fell from the not the top of the cage, but he was dangling off from the door of the cage, and he fell onto the stairway. So they say he got concussed or he knocked himself out or whatever the case may be. But apparently there's also some rumors that this is a whole angle, which is what I believe. I don't think he got knocked out. I don't think he's actually hurt. Do you?
No, it is an angle, and I did see the explanation why.
Yeah, it's because, he can't go overseas, so.
Exactly, and that is completely believable because he can't go overseas.
Right.
So.
And another thing is, from my understanding, I read this on lordsofpain.com, .net, actually, that James Storm, he apparently like attacked him after he was being taken out on a stretcher. And of course, if he was actually hurt, that would never happen. So
no, never, 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 never.
He reported this, and everybody like, are you guys fucking stupid? This is wrestling, man. Come on.
That's it, man. It's the wrestling. You can't.
Fucking the wrestling business we're talking about here, you know?
It.
The wrestling business, man.
Motherfucking wrestling, man.
It's the wrestling business where Vince McMahon got blown up in a car and he's back in 2 weeks, you know?
Yeah, thanks, Chris Benoit. God, ruined a good angle.
You're a dick.
Fucking dick. Really, you are.
Well, there you go, man. There you go, dude.
All right. Well, I guess we can end on that.
Yeah,
the Macho Man is in. We went over Raw. We talked a little Lucha. What else? You got anything else, sir?
No, I don't. Maybe depending on if I get to watch Lucha and TNA and everything, maybe we'll do another Saturday edition if you guys are down.
Maybe. We'll see. I don't know what I'm doing, if anything, this weekend. So, yeah, might be a good thing.
Yeah. We'll figure something out. We'll probably do it earlier because probably going to try to head out at night, but figure something out. If we even do it. I don't know if we're going to do it. But
yeah, we should just not even announce it.
Yeah, there you go.
We're just saying maybe, possibly. Keep your eyes open for a possible Saturday night special.
There you go. And if you didn't check out the last week's Saturday night special, definitely check that out, man, because that was a – That was a good one from what I remember, because I don't remember most of it. So.
Yeah, he doesn't remember any of it, but he thinks it was a good one. So
trust my word.
Take his word for it. It was a good one. I don't remember a thing.
In fact, don't trust my word. Go listen to it for yourself.
Listen to it. Tell us.
Judge me. Tell me if you can trust
me. Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. All
right, man.
Anyway, let's get the plugs out of here and let's get on out of here. Facebook.com/groups/THT podcast. Check us out. HotTagPodcast.Weebly.com. All the links are on there. You can check us out on iTunes. You can check us out on Stitcher, THT Wrestling Podcast. Join us on YouTube, Turnbuckle Corner, or THT Wrestling Podcast. Same with Twitter as well, THT Wrestling Podcast. So check us out, man. We're everywhere. Hang out with us via internet. And yeah, that's about it. We'll see you next Tuesday again, if not this Saturday.
That's it. We will see you soon, people. In the meantime.
Back your ass, my good man. Time to kick back, drink some beers, and smoke some weed.
Bang, bang.